other day we were talking about creating a video game, okay? And we were talking about how could we make a video game that would demonstrate or show how turtles cross the road. Because they're in some, well, some turtles are endangered species in Missouri, right?
Yeah.
All right. So we've talked about this for the Endangered Species Project, for my CBR project, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And you guys have been working on that, is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So we thought, or I started talking to you about this, and we started coming up with ideas about what kind of video game we could make that would show a turtle crossing of the road. So what ideas did we come up with, do you remember?
We could just put your enemies in there and you trying to cross the road.
Okay, so the enemies of a box turtle crossing the road are?
The cars.
The cars, very good.
Mm-hmm.
So what we decided to do was try to make a video game with a turtle crossing the road, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the so-called enemies are the cars going back and forth, right?
Mm-hmm.
So did you guys try to make games like that?
Yeah, we made three.
You made three. For you to play my game, okay, called Turtle with a Gun. Push the button to play the game. I want you to start at the same time.
Okay.
Okay, because you're kind of in a competition against each other. That's a game within a game. Kind of fun, huh? You versus your bro. Your bro versus your bro. What do you think's going to win?
I don't know.
On your marks, get set, go! And the idea here is that the award points, or reward points, are the turtles trying to find a mate.
Dang.
Turtles are trying to find a mate, or they're trying to establish territory, because that's why box turtles cross the road. And neither one of them finished third level in 1 minute. They can get hit three times. The real life turtle hit once, typically is dead, although sometimes they can get nicked and still have a piece of their shell broken and they can still survive. But, so that's kind of the idea we're playing with here, is that they could get hit three times in their lifetime and still survive. Of course, the turtle, the avatar turtle, is very slow. Turtles are slow. So that's just like a turtle, right? It's trying to find its mate and trying to establish territory.
And it's trying to find food.
Food, and he's got to cross the road sometimes to do that. Well, it's very precarious. It's very frustrating for the turtle. Turtles, they think, you know, they're out on the road, they can stick their heads in their shell, and they're safe. Of course, how many seconds, how many minutes before they get hit by a car?
Yes!
You made it in time?
Yeah!
Woo! Woo! Good job! Woo! High five! High five! Fist bump! Fist bump! Fist bump! Bump! Fist face! Oh, slap face!
Don't you feel good about yourself? Did you successfully beat that game that was so hard?
Yeah.
Yeah. Here, I'll give you a pat on the back here. Give me your back. There you go. Good job. What makes anybody go back to play any game?
They have to know if it's fun.
Okay, what makes it fun? What makes a game fun?
Challenge.
Why might you play it again?
Because it was challenging.
It was challenging? Did you think it was fun?
Yeah.
So you would do it again because you'd like to see if you could do better.
Mm-hmm.
Did you start to figure out a strategy? Like, shoot them all up first and then go get the reward points?
On my sixth and seventh try, I just, like, shot a few of them and then went right through.
Now, in nature, turtles don't have a chance. Cars versus turtles. Turtles get smushed. Turtles think that their shell is going to protect them, so they pull themselves into their shell and stop.
It's not strong enough.
He's got to rely on what he knows, and he knows that the shell protects him in almost all circumstances.
But it's safe enough to keep him safe from one of the predators that try to eat him.
So his shell protects him from other animals.
But not from cars.
So mankind, humans, we really, if we want to save those creatures, we have to watch out for them. That's the whole conservation aspect of it.
And we have to try not to make them endangered species.
And we can still teach a lesson at the same time. That's what's so exciting about using video games as teaching tools.